이번 시간에는 스룹바벨 성전.
We're going to be studying Zerubbabel's temple, and this is the 16th session.
자, 오늘은
Today,
메시아 대망 성전 이런 제목으로.
It's going to be on the temple with great expectation for the Messiah.
메시아 대망
The temple with great expectation for the Messiah.
성들이
The people of Israel, they were deported to Babylon, and this was in 537 BC. In 537 BC, this was the first return from the Babylonian captivity. And in 536 BC, they began the construction of Zerubbabel's temple.
성전 건축을 시작하죠. 그래서 사마리아 사람들을 비롯한 대적들의
Through the people of Samaria, they had many adversaries that opposed them for this construction. And for 16 years, the construction was halted. And then in the year 520 BC, the Zerubbabel's temple began its reconstruction.
시작한다. 자, 그리고 나서
And after this,
주전
In the year 516 BC, the Zerubbabel's temple was finished in terms of its construction. And this Zerubbabel's temple, when Jesus would come, it was a temple that was existing when Jesus came. So it is a temple that had a great expectation for the Messiah. In the year 4 BC, Jesus was born. And the Zerubbabel's temple had a great expectation for Jesus' coming. That's what that temple was. And the man of God, Reverend Abraham Park, in Matthew chapter 1, verse 17, divided the genealogy of Jesus into three periods. There's the first period, the second period, and the third period. In the first period, this is from beginning with Abraham and going to King David. And then the second period was from David until the deportation to Babylon. And from the deportation to Babylon to Jesus is the three periods. And we can see this in Matthew chapter 1, verse 17. When Abraham was born, he was born in the year 2166 BC. David, when he became the king over all Israel, this was in the year 1003 BC. And so the first period is from 2166 BC until 1003 BC. And this spans a time of history of 1163 years. And so 14 generations are compressed. And then from David until the deportation of Babylon, Jeconiah begins the third period of Jesus' genealogy. And Jeconiah is King Jehoiakim. And King Jehoiakim, when he was deported to Babylon, this was in the year 597 BC during the second deportation. And the second period from David to the second deportation, from 1003 to 597, this spans 406 years, and this again is compressed into 14 generations. And then the third period, from the deportation of Babylon until Jesus' birth, from 597 to the year 4 BC, this is about 593 years of history, and again, is compressed into 14 generations. Why then in Matthew chapter 1 is the number 14 being used?
7이 완전수인데
7 is the perfect number, but we can see that 7 plus 7 is 14, and so 14 speaks of perfection and then perfection again. And this number 14,
태음력, 태음력. 달과 관계가 있어요.
There's a relation to the calendar.
14일을 기준으로 해서 바뀌거든요.
And it speaks of the lunar calendar.
And
so if the moon starts out smaller, but then it gets bigger and bigger, right? And so until the full moon, it takes 14 days. And then when the moon gets smaller, it takes 14 days, and when it gets bigger again, it's 14 days. And so when we look at the three periods of Jesus' genealogy, we look at the maturation of Israel's history. It begins with Abraham and goes until King David, and we reach the pinnacle, and we see this maturation. And then from David's sin, we can see how the history of Israel begins to fall. And we see the decline of the history of Israel. And then the third period, after the deportation of Babylon, the people of Israel are being restored. And we can see that they're being restored from Babylon. The point where we divide the second and the third period is in the year 597 BC. And so from 597 to 4 BC, we see 537 BC is encompassed here. And so this time period
is
that the Israelites were deported to Babylon, but they would not meet their end forever, but that they would in fact be restored again. And so God does not kill everyone off for all eternity. Man says you need to kill them, right? Step on them. But God, because he loves us so much, he does not completely kill off people, does not completely step on people. When the time comes, God will in fact restore them. And so we have hope. Your mother who gave birth to you, even if she may forget you, God will not forget you. And so he will restore them, but how are they restored? Through the Messiah. Through Jesus' coming, all things will be restored, and that's what it is teaching us. And so all of the prophets spoke of the Messiah that was to come, and when he comes, all things will be restored. We will be liberated from sin, we will be liberated from death, all things will be liberated. We will be liberated from all pain and suffering. And it teaches of the ideology of this great expectation for the Messiah. And this ideology of the great expectation for the Messiah, the time that this was very much in earnest was in this time period here. And the temple that was existing at that time was the Zerubbabel's temple. And so the Zerubbabel's temple was what? The temple that had a great expectation for the Messiah. And so the time period that yearned for the Messiah the most was the time when the Zerubbabel's temple was built. And if, when Jesus comes, all things will be restored. And so there's a people that had a withered hand. It says, put out your hand, and that hand was restored. And if you obey the word of Jesus and you hold on to Jesus, all of the wrong things, all the things that have gone wrong will be restored. And so for all of you, no matter what issues may be in your families or in your workplaces, the one that can restore all things is Jesus. When you hold on to Jesus and pray to him, the living Father God will restore all things. Please believe in this. And so this was the introduction that the Zerubbabel's temple was a temple that had a great expectation for the Messiah. And this temple that had this great expectation, what Messiah did they have this expectation of? It was for a greater glory and a Messiah that would give peace. It was for a greater glory and the Messiah that would give peace. In our main scripture text today in Haggai chapter 2, verse 9, let us read this all together. Haggai chapter 2, verse 9, today's main scripture text. Ready, begin. The latter glory of this house will be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will give peace, declares the Lord of hosts.
So, 여기
Here, the expression this house, this house, this speaks of, in Chinese characters, it speaks of the temple. This house, it speaks of the Zerubbabel's temple, because they're building the Zerubbabel's temple. The latter glory of this house will be greater than the former, it says. And so the Messiah would in fact come, but the Messiah would give a greater glory, and that's what it is testifying. So first, it speaks of a greater glory. A greater glory will be given. And so first, it says that this latter glory will be greater than the former. Here, it's, this house speaks of the temple, but when we look later on, it says that the latter glory and the former glory, it speaks of the glory of the past, the glory from before. And so the former glory, the Zerubbabel's temple, before it was built, there was a glory that existed. So before the Zerubbabel's temple, what was there? It was the Solomon's temple. And so before, this speaks of the past, this speaks of the glory of Solomon's temple. The glory of Solomon's temple. And so Solomon's temple, how majestically was it built? Before David died, all of the gold and the jewels were preserved, and that's how it was built. And it was a very majestic temple. But no matter how great that glory was of the Solomon's temple, going forward, when Jesus would come, the glory he gives would be greater than that. And so the glory, the former glory speaks of the Solomon's temple. In 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 11, when Solomon's temple was built, the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord. I'm going to read 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 11 for you. 1 Kings 8, 11. So that the priests could not stand to minister because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord. The glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord. If we write in Hebrew, it's ha rishon.
Ha rishon.
Ha rishon.
과거에.
And this speaks of the in the past. Rishon.
처음이란 뜻이에요.
It means at the beginning.
처음의 영광이.
The glory at the beginning, or the glory of the past. And so it speaks of the glory of the Solomon's temple. The glory of Solomon's temple, no matter how majestic it was, when Jesus comes, Jesus would come to the Zerubbabel's temple, and the glory that Jesus would give is the latter glory, but it would be greater than the former. And so we're going to look at the latter glory. Secondly, the latter glory.
이전의 영광이 커요. 나중
is the latter glory greater or the former glory greater? The latter is greater. And so this latter glory,
오실 때
when Jesus comes, there will be a glory that he will bring with him.
오실 때
when Jesus comes,
가져오시는 영광.
He will bring a glory with him.
그래서 요한복음 1장 14절에
and so in John chapter 1 verse 14 when we read there it says that the word became flesh and dwelt among us and we saw his glory. Glory as of the only begotten from the Father, it says. Glory as of the only begotten from the Father. This begotten Son, it speaks of his glory. And also in Luke chapter 2, verse 32, the glory of Jesus is the glory of Israel. It is the glory of Israel. That's the expression that is being made. Jesus was the Word that became flesh to this earth, and he would have the glory of the Father, of the only begotten of the Father, and it is the glory of Israel.
나중 영광.
This latter glory, this word, the word latter,
히브리어로
in Hebrew,
하아하론이라는 단어예요.
It's 하아하론.
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 하
하아하론. 아하론.
그래서 이 아하론이라는
And this expression 아하론
이것은 종말에
This means at the end.
At the 마지막에 end
or
it
speaks of in its finality or at the end or finally.
이 나중 영광은
And so this latter glory
When
at Jesus' first coming will reveal his glory, but at the same time, when the Lord returns again, it speaks of that glory. Why? When the Lord returns again, the end of redemptive history, at the finality of redemptive history, this word latter, ha-aharon, it speaks of the glory of the end, the final glory, the final glory, when the Lord returns again, that speaks of that glory. In Matthew chapter 16, verse 27,
주님 초림하실 때 요한복음 1장 14절에 the Lord came in
John chapter 1 verse 14 was the glory begotten of the Father. But in Matthew chapter 16 verse 27 it says the Son of Man is going to come and he will come in the glory of his Father, it says. He will come in the glory of his Father. That's what it says. And so very clearly, the Son of Man will come in the glory of the Father, and that glory will be revealed at the end.
And so that glory,
no matter how great the glory of Solomon's temple was, it will be even greater than that. And that's what it is teaching us. The glory of Solomon's temple was very majestic. Because God's glory appeared there. However, Jesus is coming to this earth. God who came in the form of man, it was not as a shadow, but he came in human form. And that glory was an even greater glory and is the glory of the Father. And that's how the Bible is expressing it. Let's find Matthew chapter 16, verse 27 and read it together. Matthew chapter 16, verse 27.
다 같이 읽겠습니다.
Let's read it all together. Matthew chapter 16, verse 27. Ready, begin.
인자가
For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and will then repay every man according to his deeds.
각 사람의 못대로 갚으리라.
What will he do? He will repay every man according to his deeds.
아유, 오늘 힘든데.
Today we're just tired. Let's just not go to Deborah Choir today. Oh, how bad is it to just miss one time?
But
it's going to be according to your deeds. What will he do? He will repay according to your deeds. As much as I've reaped, it's going to be recorded in heaven. God will bless me according to what I've done. And so today the Son of Man will come in the glory of the Father. When that happens, he will repay every person according to their deeds. And I pray that we will be able to receive these blessings. Now look here. The moment that this appears, when we look at its present state,
지금 이 말씀이 나오는 현재 상태는
the 이제 word in this present state
다시 건축을 재시작했잖아요.
The Zerubbabel's temple is being reconstructed, right?
16년 동안 중단되었다가
For 16 years it was halted and now it is being rebuilt,
했잖아요.
right?
그래 가지고 이렇게
And so on the ground, there's a foundation for the building, and they begin to build the temple. And so when you look at its present state, there's just really nothing to see. I mean, it is just... It is just nothing to see here. And that's the state of it. And from this state, God says, this house, in this house, the latter glory is going to be greater than that of Solomon's temple. It will be even more majestic, and that's the word that he was proclaiming. But in his present state, the Zerubbabel's temple that we're looking at, there was nothing to see. It was very bare. Now, what is that? In its present state, from your tragic circumstances, don't look at its bare circumstances, but going forward, it will be greater than the Solomon's temple of the past, and that glory will come upon this place. And he's saying, have that expectation. That kind of a hope is being given through the prophet Haggai to the people of Israel. And so for the one that looks at the latter glory, then I will change into that. In my life will be changed into a glorious life. It is very important in terms of what people are looking at. There will be a person that will look at coins on the ground and they'll pick it up. And they're overjoyed with that because they did it when they were younger. And from that point forward, they're just looking down at the ground. And so for their entire life, they were just looking at the things that were on the ground and they picked that up. And so when you calculate what they've picked up, they were able to pick up maybe 57,000 buttons or pieces of iron. You see how much they've collected. But because you just look at the ground, they become someone that just looks in the ground. But if we look upon the glory of God, then we will be changed into glorious beings. What did Jesus say? Hey, your bodies are frail, and you're in such pain, and you're going through such afflictions, and you're fatigued and going through difficulties. It's difficult for us to even maintain our bodies, and it tells us it's difficult to live this life. And this speaks of our weak bodies, our frail bodies. But these mortal bodies will be changed into the glorious bodies like the Lord. And so our mortal bodies will be changed into glorious bodies, will be done, but we must do that by looking to Jesus when he comes again. And so then my life will be changed into one of a glorious life. If I just look at the ground, then I will just be one that always looks at the ground. It is very important to know what people look at. In Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, it says, faith is the assurance of things hoped for. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for, and it will actually become a reality. And so God, in terms of the Zerubbabel temple, was saying, do not just look at the frail circumstances of this temple, but look to the great glory that will come upon this house in the future. So for all of you today, whatever your circumstances may be, do not just look at that, but look at when the Father comes again, that we will all be changed into the spiritual bodies and that a reward will be given to us. Look to that glory. Because if we do that, then my life will be changed over into a glorious life. And if I'm changed over into a glorious life, then I will have hope, my body will become more healthy, and I will be able to have this drive to do more things. Then the wrinkles will disappear, and you'll have a vibrancy to your life. So let us not just tragically look at the ground, but let's look to the heavens. Where is our citizenship? It says our citizenship is in heaven. In Philippians chapter 3, verse 20, it says this, that our citizenship is in heaven. And so we are waiting for the one that will come again. In verse 21, our mortal bodies will be changed into bodies of glory. Let's read Philippians chapter 3, verses 20 and 21 together. Philippians chapter 3, verse 20 and 21. Let's read it all together. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which also we eagerly wait for a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform the body of our humble state into conformity with the body of his glory by the exertion of the power that is even to subject all things to himself. Amen. How wonderful is that? And so originally, The manuscript that our friend and pastor wrote on, the Ezekiel's temple and the Zerubbabel's temple is contained together. And we're trying to publish it together, but it comes to about 700 to 800 pages. And so if one book is 700 or 800 pages, all of you will become very bored with it. And so the 12th book of the history of the Empty, we're going to give it in two volumes. Book 11 will be in two volumes. One will be for the Ezekiel's temple and the other for Zerubbabel's temple. So please pray fervently. To publish a book is not an easy thing. The manuscripts that our founding pastor wrote, we're trying to change it into contemporary terminologies. We have to put a title, and we have to edit it, and we have to put in the Greek and the Hebrew and the English, and all of those necessities, we're trying to put those things in. And so, it is very time-consuming, and so please pray so that at the end of this year, the Ezekiel's temple, when that book is published, all of the Korean churches and their denominations will be shocked with that word. May many nations come before the word of redemptive history. So we ask for your prayers. And so the Zerubbabel's temple, its present state is very bare, frail. And that's written in Haggai chapter 2, verse 3. And Haggai chapter 2, verse 3.
시작.
Ready, begin. Who is left among you who saw this temple in its former glory? And how do you see it now? Does it not seem to you like nothing in comparison? Right? It looks like nothing. And so they're all disappointed and they're in despair. But hey, do not despair. This temple, its latter glory will be greater than the former glory of the Solomon's temple. It will be more majestic, and God will give his blessings and his reward to all of you. And that word was proclaimed through the prophet Haggai. So for all of you, no matter what your circumstances may be right now, do not look at your present circumstances, but look at the latter glory and arise with hope. And I pray these blessings upon all of you in the name of the Lord. If we organize this, the Zerubbabel's temple was a temple that had a great expectation from the Messiah. And so first we spoke of a greater glory, the Messiah that gives a greater glory and peace. The Messiah who gives a greater glory and peace. And so first, it is the Messiah who gives a greater glory. The Messiah who gives a greater glory. And we studied up until here. And then secondly, it is the Messiah who gives peace. It is the Messiah who gives peace. Earlier in Haggai chapter 2, verse 9, it says, I will give peace. So going forward, the Messiah would come and the Messiah would give peace. And Jesus actually came and gave peace. Now the peace that Jesus gives, what kind of peace is it? First, it is a peace that the world cannot give. It is a peace that the world cannot give. In John chapter 14, verse 27, it says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you, not as the world gives do I give to you. So do not let your heart be troubled, nor let it be fearful. The peace that the world gives, the peace that the world gives, it looks like peace, but within that, there is distress and fear contained within it. There's always trouble and fear contained within it. So this peace, it speaks of a false peace. But the peace that Jesus gives, it is not like the peace that the world gives, because there will be no trouble or no fear. And so we must receive the peace that Jesus gives. This peace in Hebrew is the word shalom. Shalom.
Shalom. 샬롬. 이것은 샬롬. 예수님이 주시는 평화예요.
This speaks of the peace that Jesus gives. It is not the peace that the world gives.
그래서 이제 이 세상에 주는 평안을
And so the peace that the world gives
그 당시에
At that time
그 예수님 당시에는
During the time of Jesus
로마가 줬잖아요.
was a peace that Rome gave.
로마라고 부르죠. 팍스 로마나.
We call it
로마,
Pax Romana.
로마나. 로마가 주는 평화다.
It is a peace that Rome gives. The peace that Rome gave was a false peace.
가짜 평화는 뭐냐?
What is false peace?
어떤 나라의 강대국의
It speaks of the military force of a nation by using the military force of a nation they're making peace.
그러나 그 평화는
But that peace is a forced peace. The peace that the world gives
세상이 주는 평화는
The peace of the world
이것은 일시적인 평안이죠.
It is a temporary peace.
일시적이다.
It is a temporary peace.
이 팍스 로마나가요.
Pax Romana
주전 27년
In the year 27 BC
아우구스투스 아우구스투스 황제 때부터 시작해 가지고
Emperor Augustus began and carried on until 180 AD
마르쿠스 아우렐리우스 황제까지
until emperor Marcus Aurelius
아우구스투스 황제로부터 시작해 가지고
from emperor Augustus
아우렐리우스
to Marcus Aurelius to Marcus Aurelius until that emperor from 27 BC to 180 AD for about 200 years Rome gave peace to the world and so they call this Pax Romana but this is a temporary peace right now it's we call it Pax Americana it is peace that America gives And they call it Pax Americana. But that peace is just a temporary peace. It is not eternal. Secondly, the peace that the world gives is with power or with military might. It is an authoritative or militaristic or a powerful peace.
세 번째로 세상이 주는 평화는
so the peace that the world gives also has trouble and fear contained within it.
그러나 예수님이 주신 평화는
But the peace that Jesus gives is an eternal peace.
그리고 이것은 힘에 의해서 유지되는
And this is not something that's given by power but a peace given in love.
말씀에 의해서 유지되는
It is maintained through the word. And the third, there is no trouble and no fear in that peace. In John chapter 14, verse 27, he says, My peace I give to you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. So do not let your heart be troubled, nor let it be fearful. And so today, the peace that Jesus gives, may it overflow in your families, and I pray these blessings upon all of you in the name of the Lord.
다음에 두 번째.
And then secondly,
어떤 예수님이 주시는 평강은 어떤 평강이냐?
What peace does Jesus give?
평강의 왕이 주시는 평강.
It is a peace that is given by the King of Peace.
주시는 평강.
It is a peace that is given by the Prince of Peace.
이것은 무슨 말씀이냐면 최고의 평강이라는 거예요.
It speaks of the very best peace.
아니 신하가 주는 평강이 아니라
It is not a peace that is given by a messenger or a peace that's given by the people but the one that is the king of peace gives this peace. It is it the greatest kind of peace it is? It's the first kind of peace. We are first peace church, right? The peace that the king of peace gives, we are overflowing with that peace.
이사야 9장 6절에
And so in Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6 it describes Jesus as the prince of peace.
요한복음
Also in John chapter 20 verse 19
21절 26절에도
19 verse 21 verse 26 after Jesus resurrected the disciples locked the door and were trembling in fear but Jesus came in he transcended time and space and said peace be with you.
그 평강은
that peace
완전히 모든 두려움과 의심을 완전히 박살내는.
It actually destroys all fear within our hearts. So it is the very best kind of peace.
우리 교회가 Today, 최고의 church, 평강을 받아들이는
May we be a church that inherits this very best kind of peace.
사람들이 But 최고의 people, 평강 그러면
When they speak of the very best kind of peace, they look only think of the good things.
평강의 왕이 주시는 최고의 평강이다.
This is a peace of the Prince of Peace, and so how wonderful will that be?
최고의 평강을
And they
좋게만 생각을 하는.
I think of this peace in only a good way. Now think about this.
예수님의 제자들이
Jesus' disciples.
너희에게 평강이 있을지어다.
He said, "Peace be with you," and they received that gift from him.
그런데 이 예수님의 제자들이
But Jesus' disciples,
세상적으로 볼 때,
from the worldly perspective,
세상적으로 볼 때 성공했나요?
Were they successful?
세상적으로는 성공하지 못했어요.
They were unsuccessful
제자들이,
in worldly terms.
돈이 있었어요.
The disciples, did they have money? Did they have some type of fame?
전부 다가
All of them. All of them were martyred. Peace be with you. And the disciples said, Amen. But these people that received this peace, they were all martyred. And after they received this peace as a gift, they were continued to flee, being persecuted. They lived in persecution continually. And so when we look at it, he should not have said, peace be with you. Why would he say this, peace be with you, but now we're being persecuted and in tribulation? But with this continual persecution and tribulation, ultimately through the disciples, the word continued to be expanded. The word was continued to be expanded. And Acts chapter 19, verse 20, it says that the word of the Lord was growing mightily and prevailing. And so they were persecuted and in tribulation, and as they were enduring this, the word was growing mightily and prevailing. And so this ultimately, through this continual persecution and tribulation, it speaks of God's redemptive history was able to progress forward until its consummation. And so God's providence of redemptive administration continued to progress forward, and it went on to consummation, and this is the true peace.
그리고 우리가 거기에 쓰임 받는 것이 진정한
And
평강이에요.
Us being used for that is the true peace. In this world, we are always going through tribulations or persecutions being called heretics. But the disciples, in the midst of that persecution and tribulation, all of them were martyred. But the disciples, all of them, they are seated next to God on the 12 thrones and are ruling over the 12 tribes. In heaven, they are receiving, they receive a great blessing in heaven. So for all of us, we think about being successful in the world, making a lot of money, and we think of that as peace, but that is a false peace. That is not peace. For that household, tribulations do not stop. But through that tribulation, the reach of the word is expanded and God's redemptive history is progressing forward, then that is true peace. That is an astounding word. We must understand the providence of God. May we not just look at our present circumstances in this world, but look to the latter glory. To the final glory and live in hope so that we can overcome the persecutions and tribulations in our life. Through the Zerubbabel's temple, God gave this type of vision to the people of Israel. So today, going forward, may the Messiah give us a greater glory and give eternal peace. May we look with great expectation and hope to that Messiah so that we may be able to penetrate through any persecution and tribulations in our life. And I pray these blessings upon all of you in the name of the Lord. We'll study up until here today. We'll now pray for the offering.
봉헌하는 시간입니다. 봉헌위원들은 준비해 주시길 바랍니다. 다 같이 기도하시겠습니다. 고맙고 감사하신 살아계시는 하나님 아버지 은혜를 감사합니다. 이렇게 목요 구구 예배로 인도해 주시고 주신 말씀을 통해서 큰 은혜 받게 해주시니 참으로 감사함을 드립니다. 날마다 주님의 영광만을 바라볼 수 있도록 인도하여 주시고 그리스도의 참 평강이 우리의 마음을 주전케 하여 주시고 마침내 최후 승리할 수 있는 모두가 될 수 있도록 인도하여 주시옵소서. 반바운의 감사하며 하나님 아버지께 봉헌하고자 합니다. 깊게 흥량하여 주시고 예물에 담긴 모든 소원과 기도 제목들이 다 응답받을 수 있도록 역사하여 주시옵소서. 바친 손길들 아버지께서 기억해 주셔서 하늘문을 열어주시사 천천만만의 큰 복으로 갚아주시는 놀라운 역사가 나타날 수 있도록 축복하여 주시옵소서. 이 헌금이 쓰인 곳마다 아버지의 영광만이 나타나게 도와주시고 구속사 지경이 더욱 넓어질 수 있도록 인도하여 주시옵소서. 모든 것을 맡기면서 예수 그리스도 이름으로 간절히 기도합니다. 아멘. 광고 시간입니다. 2019년 8월 22일 August
22nd, 2019, Thursday worship service announcements.
첫 번째 광고로
First announcement,
성경 구속사 세미나가 아래와 같이 개최됩니다. 8월 23일부터 24일까지 캐나다 토론토 산소망교회에서 8월 26일부터 31일까지 콜롬비아 에콰도르에서 8월 31일 미얀마 9월 3일 부산 은혜 교회에서 9월 12일은 프랑스 파리에서 구속사 세미나가 있습니다. 마지막 광고로
Final announcement. The second book of the Pisan Sermon Book, Absolute Thanksgiving from an Empty Heart, was completely sold out, so it is going through its second printing. Starting next weekend, you can purchase at the Kyobo Bookstore, Inner Park, Yeongpun Bookstore, or Aladdin, or any other bookstores that sell books, you can actually purchase this book. Let us rise and sing the final hymn and conclude with a benediction.
아버지 하나님의 만극하신 사랑하심과 성령님의 감동 감화 내주 충만 교통하심이 오늘도 현재보다 내 나중의 영광을 바라보며 소망 가운데 모든 어둠의 세력과 싸워 승리하기를 소망하는 귀한 성도들 머리 위에 그들의 가정과 직장과 생업과 섬기시는 교회 위에 이제로부터 영원 영원토록 함께 있을지어다.
아멘.
순서를 마쳤습니다. 편히 귀가하시기를 바랍니다.